What up, guys? Welcome back. So today, we're finally going to talk about the AirPods Pro 2, who they're for, who they're not for, if I think they are worth the price. You know, Apple has that price tag. We're paying for that Apple tax here, but are they worth that? Now, we're going to talk about these. You guys know if you follow the channel, I was a big fan of the original AirPods Pro, good at everything. These are improved in every way over the original AirPods. And if you're new to the channel, guys, hit that like, drop a sub. But let's talk about the AirPods Pro 2. $229 is the price tag. And even on Black Friday, maybe we'll get 5, 10, 15, 20 bucks off. And that's a big maybe. Usually Apple products do not go on sale. And if they do, it's not very much. So $229 is the price. And that's what we're going to go forward thinking about these at that price point. So right off the bat, again, if you are not in the Apple ecosystem, these earbuds are simply not for you. There are better options out there if you have an Android device. Whatever Android device you are using, AirPods Pro, AirPods Pro 2, whatever it is, do not buy them. It's really simple. There are much, much better options. And again, if you want to know what those options are, drop a comment. I'll get videos made. I'll reach out to you. Hit me up on Twitter. Up here, you can find me on Twitter and Instagram. Reach out and I'll tell you what options are available if you are an Android user. But if you have an iPhone, you're going to want to watch this video because these are really good earbuds. Let's talk about them. All right, guys, I want to take a quick minute to talk about something very important. Beats for Hope and El Jefe Reviews, they've been working together for a while with Jeff's line of t-shirts and hoodies and apparel, and we are going to help support that here on the channel. So 100% of the proceeds for every t-shirt sold will go and help feed a family and give a meal to a family in need. This is his latest design here, supporting and honoring his late and beautiful wife, Paloma, who sadly passed away recently. So 100% of the proceeds, guys, will go towards feeding a family. You get a dope t-shirt, and you get to help support this fantastic cause. We are using our platforms as creators to help put food on the table for local families in need. There are t-shirts, hoodies, women's shirts available in all sizes, ranging from small to 5X. Again, it's a win-win. You get a dope shirt. You get to help feed a family in need. Beats for Hope is a nonprofit that is a volunteer-based company and a unique platform that brings music and people together to make a difference in the community. Now, the packaging on the AirPods Pro 2, very similar to the AirPods Pro, the originals, and really every other AirPods version that Apple does come out with. And there will be a ton of clones on these things. The paperwork on here, typical paperwork. Couple different languages, very simple, very straightforward. Now we do get the USB-C to Lightning, still a Lightning on here, but it is what it is. This will change eventually, and we do get some extra tips: small, medium, large, and or extra small, small, medium, and large. I did replace the mediums that do come stock out of the box with the large ear tips on here, and then we actually have the AirPods. These are going to look very much like the original AirPod Pros. You can tell the difference. There are vents on here, two vents instead of one like on the originals, and the mics are in different placements. But other than that, it will be hard to tell them apart. Now, you can tell the case apart. There are speakers now on the bottom of the case. There is also a spot for a lanyard here, not included. You will have to get your own lanyard if you want to do that. But other than that, everything will look the same. Same size, pretty much the same everything except for those vents, the mics, the lanyard spot, and of course the speakers on the case. But it is improved. Now, battery life on here is also improved. The originals, I would only get 3.5 to 4 hours of battery life with ANC on. I am getting around 5.5 to 6 hours with ANC on with these earbuds. And with ANC off, I am getting around 8 hours of battery life on the AirPods Pro 2, just using transparency mode or something like that. Now, with the case, I couldn't really test the case. If you want to see how much we are getting extra charges with the case, check out some other creators and their videos. They are saying you can get around 30 hours with ANC on and about 40 hours with ANC off. But my situation is a little different. My case does not work. I get one charge out of this case. I'm not sure why, but it will not recharge these headphones more than one time. I constantly have to charge the case. It is unfortunate, but that is, that's just my experience with the AirPods Pro 2. My case gets one charge and that is it, unfortunately. Now, if we take these out again, you do have to like the stem style earbuds, and not long stems, but they are stems nonetheless. So again, stem style earbuds on here. So you do have to like these types of earbuds. Now, again, these are squeezed to touch, but they did include, and, you know, we can thank the clones for this one, the swipe. We now have volume, swipe up and swipe down on the AirPods Pro 2. And I have some older videos with some AirPod Pro clones where they did include a swipe gesture. And that's exactly where Apple got this from, a swipe gesture to control volume up and volume down. And we still have to pinch to get the regular controls. And you can hold to scroll through ANC transparency mode or completely turn it off. Now, the rest of the specs on the AirPods Pro 2, IPX4, sweat and water resistant. So not waterproof. So don't submerge these. Don't shower with these. Just your basic IPX4 resistance when it comes to water. Spatial audio, which is improved. And you can customize kind of your spatial audio inside of Apple's settings, which I will show you. ANC, it is improved. Transparency mode, it is improved. The mics on here, still excellent. AirPods have always had some of the best mics in the earbud game, and these are no different. Wireless charging compatible. This is key wireless charging compatible, as well as MagSafe charging compatible. I'll show you that. Now, this also does have the improved H2 chip over the H1 chip, which should help improve the battery life, which it does. And overall, that's pretty much it when it comes to what these things have to offer. But let's go in. We're going to check out the settings inside of the iPhone. Again, I hate to call this an app. It's not really an app. It's in settings. Once you connect it to Bluetooth, you guys know how this works. You click on the little blue button in there, and it does bring us to kind of an app. It looks like an app, but it's just a menu with options. All right, now we'll just open up the case, and we will go into the settings. We'll get that pop-up animation that we all love with AirPods. Every model of AirPods has the pop-up animation. Even the Bits models that Apple makes gives us that pop-up, and a lot of other companies are now starting to do that. I'm a big fan of that. Now, if we click on here, this info button, again, this will not be available on Android devices. Another reason, this is why you don't buy these if you have an Android device. But if you have an iPhone, you click on the little blue button here, it takes us in to the menu, and you get the battery percentages up top. You can change the name if you want. Your transparency mode off or noise cancellation. Again, you can control this directly from just squeezing and holding on the stems of the AirPod Pros 2. Now, your transparency mode on here is adaptive, so it will adjust depending on your surroundings. It will adjust. So, look, if you have transparency mode on and you're letting in all of that outside noise, if something loud does come, a car accident, whatever it is, it will adjust so it doesn't, you know, hurt your ears in any way. And the noise cancellation on here. We're going to talk about how good those are because they are improved from the originals, and the originals were already very good. Now, your press and hold, you can change this if you want to Siri, but we'll leave it right where it is now. Now, your ear tip fit test, you want to do that to get that good seal. Make sure you try that out. Now, you can turn, we just talked about adaptive transparency. You can turn that on or off. Automatic ear detection. This is, of course, if we are playing music or listening to content and I want to take an earbud out, it will automatically pause, put it back in, and it will play. It does work very well. Connect this to this iPhone automatically. We do want to do that. Now, personalized spatial audio. This is very cool. I do have it on right now. And what it does, it will take kind of a snapshot of the front of your head. Then you'll have to turn one direction to the right, one direction to the left, and it will take kind of pictures of your ears. You have to move around a little bit, and so it can track. It's head tracking, and it's kind of getting an idea of the shape of your face, the shape of the sides of your head, to give it a more personalized head tracking when it does spatial audio. Your microphone on here, enable. So you can disable the charging sounds on the actual case. Optimize battery charging, which for me, it's irrelevant because my case does not charge or does not hold a charge, I should say. And the model name, model number, there will be updates for these moving forward. But that is basically everything inside of the menu. And again, you do not have access to this on an Android device. Now, let's talk about transparency mode and active noise cancellation. Transparency mode, in my opinion, on the original AirPod Pros, one of the best you can buy on any pair of earbuds. And these are improved. These are excellent. I'm using them right now to talk. Not really any white noise coming in. Very natural, very clean. It's like I'm just talking without earbuds in my ears. It's really, really good. And one of the best you are going to find anywhere on any pair of earbuds. Really good job with transparency. Once again, Apple. Now the noise cancellation, again, excellent. The AirPods Pro did everything well. The originals did everything well. Everything was really good and really strong. Not the best in any one thing, but really, really good. ANC on here is improved. Top notch, top tier ANC. It drowns out a ton of, well, all of the low rumbles and some of the voices it will drown out. ANC on here is excellent. Very strong, very powerful when it comes to that. So as far as ANC goes and transparency mode goes, these are worth the price point of these because we're paying, you know, these are expensive. $229 for a pair of earbuds in today's market is very expensive. And the ANC and transparency mode on here deliver.
Now we're going to talk about the microphones on the AirPods Pro 2. So mics on AirPods, it really doesn't matter. The originals all the way up to the AirPods Pro 2. Even the regular versions, the AirPods 2, the AirPods 3 have always had excellent microphones. Let me know what you think of the mics on the AirPods Pro 2.
All right, guys, spatial audio on the AirPods Pro 2. It is definitely improved over the originals. The originals, it was kind of the start of the tech for spatial audio, and it was good. This is better. This is that fully immersive experience, and you can go in and you can personalize it. It will track your head. It will give you that immersive experience. You can control it from the earbuds here. It does say, where's it at on here? You can turn on spatial audio in Control Center, just touch and hold the volume slider, then tap spatial audio, and it gives you that full immersive experience. The AirPods Pro 2 do it very well and much better than the originals, in my opinion. I'm a big fan of spatial audio on this, and now there are some other earbuds that have spatial audio. So I like that more and more companies now are implementing and giving us spatial audio on the earbuds because I'm a big fan of spatial audio. Now, volume and sound quality on AirPods Pro 2. Volume-wise, these are good. They're not great. There are louder earbuds out there, but these are loud enough for anybody. You shouldn't be listening to these at full volume anyway. I don't think anybody will have an issue with how loud these get. And, of course, the sound quality on the AirPods Pro 2. The AirPods Pro did everything very well, like I said earlier in the video, and sound quality was included in that. They sounded good to me. They had some good bass. They had some good highs. The mids were good and clear. Not the best in any way or in any one area. These are improved upon in every single way when it comes to sound quality. There's better bass. The highs are nice and bright. They're not overly bright where it's going to affect you and be an issue. They sound clear. The mids sound really good on here. They're just a good sounding pair of earbuds. There's some good bass. If you're a crazy bass head and you want that crazy thump, that's not what these are, but there is some good bass. I do enjoy listening to the AirPods Pro 2. These have been my gym earbuds now for a few weeks. I go back and forth between these and some other earbuds, but lately it's been these, and these at work also, especially for the mics on here. But the spatial audio on here, combined with how these sound, they're just a good solid pair of earbuds. Now look, as I mentioned earlier in the video, if you have an Android device, these are not for you. It's very simple, very straightforward. You cannot take full advantage of what these have to offer if you do not have an iPhone. So iPhone users, there are also better earbuds out there. Like these are expensive. We're paying for that Apple tax. These are really good earbuds. Now, if you have the original AirPod Pros, should you upgrade to the AirPod Pros 2? The answer is no, you should not. As good as these are, the AirPod Pros are not far behind. So do I think you should upgrade? No. Just enjoy the AirPod Pros for now because there's no reason to upgrade, especially at this price. If these were a little cheaper, maybe, but probably not even then. The AirPod Pros are still a very good pair of earbuds. So who are these for? If you have never tried, or if you are just looking for an Apple product when it comes to earbuds and you don't have the AirPod Pros and you're coming from the AirPod 2s or the original AirPods, these are a great upgrade if you are coming from a pair of earbuds like that. So if you have an Android device, don't buy these. If you have the AirPod Pros, don't buy these. Anybody else, these are fair game. Just know you are paying that Apple tax, but they are a very good pair of earbuds. Hopefully your case will work because mine does not. It holds one charge and one charge only. But that's it, guys. The AirPod Pros 2. Let me know what you think. Hit that like, drop a sub. I'll be back soon. Peace.